Cruz again, back at the arena in Philadelphia, where we're just about set for the main goal of the evening. And if any of you saw the last time these two fighters, Bobby Jones and Gil Turner, matched, you know you're in for a whale of an evening. For Bobby Jones, after 9 years of fighting and being among the have-nots in boxing, his upset victory over Gil Turner the last time out was the big point in his boxing life. And he wants to nail that victory down with another one tonight. For Gil Turner, it means a great deal in ring prestige to avenge that defeat. So these two boys have a very important fight on their hands tonight, and we're ready with it. And here is the ring announcer, Pete Byron.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce at this time some of the outstanding boxers in the country, two leading heavyweight contenders, Boardwalk Billy Smith. Clarence Henry. The most sensational welterweight of the present time, from Trenton, New Jersey, Georgie Johnson. Number one light heavy contender from Philadelphia, Harold Johnson. This is the feature bout, 10 rounds. The officials appointed by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission, Chairman Frank Wiener, judging James Mina, Nate Lopenson, counting for the knockdowns, Joe Servino, your timekeeper, Charlie Cunningham, the commission doctor in attendance at the ringside, Dr. Joseph Bartone, and your referee, Zach Clayton. Wearing white trunks with a black stripe, weighing 154 and one half pounds, from Oakland, California, Bobby Jones. And his opponent, wearing black trunks with a white stripe, weighing 152 and one half pounds, from Philadelphia, Gil Turner. 10 rounds, another 6-round bout will follow.
Men, this is your fight. The only reason I'm here to see the rules and regulations are carried out. That I intend to do.
Refreshing of the boxing rules to both the fighters, pointing up the high spots. They, of course, have been thoroughly instructed by the Pennsylvania Boxing Commission. Frank Wiener, the chairman here in Pennsylvania. In the white trunks and with his robe off is Bobby Jones of Oakland, California. He came in weighing 154 and a half at the weigh-in today, and still with his robe slung loosely over his shoulders is the Philadelphia boy, Gil Turner, and he weighed in at 152 and a half, just a 2-pound weight difference between the two. This is Bobby Jones as he returns to his corner. Buzzer. 10 seconds to go to round number one. A little short 10 seconds. There it was. Jones in the white trunks, Turner in the black. In the rousing battle these two fought a few weeks ago here in Philadelphia, Turner carried the fight to Bobby Jones, moving in on him throughout, and Jones scored his upset victory largely through highly effective counterpunching. So we may see Turner a little bit more careful about rushing Bobby Jones in the course of tonight's fight. Certainly he's starting out that way. Thank you. staying exclusively with their jabs in a sort of a probing first round. Jones would like to see Turner in the black trunks come to him again. The chances are excellent he'll have to alter the style of fighting that won for him the last time around. To go in the first round, and the switchover in styles is becoming apparent as Jones now is beginning to move after Turner, and Turner is backing away, looking for the opportunity for counters. Number one, and here's Bobby Jones out of Oakland, California. He's been fighting for a long time and just got up there with that upset victory over Gil Turner the last time they met. He got into fighting when, as a youngster, he had a shoe shining stand and found himself in the position of having to defend it periodically. He defended it with enough success that he got interested in boxing. Never fought amateur. 13 days after he decided to turn fighter and went into a gym to begin working out, he had his first fight, a professional fight, and he won it. Has four youngsters ranging in age from 9 to 1.5. Irving Jr., better known as Butch, Howard, Robert Lee, and Rosella. Across the ring, Gil Turner is sitting quietly. It was a quiet first round, and Turner reversed his style of the previous meeting, particularly in the closing minute of the round, by doing the backpedaling and forcing Jones to come to him. Bobby Jones in the white trunks, Gil Turner in the black. Turner's manager, George Katz, says that win, lose, or draw tonight, Turner is going to return to the welterweight ranks. Apparently, there's no problem making the 147-pound weight limit. There's a minute to go in the second round, but we're in a situation of fighters going into styles in which neither is at home. This is forced upon Jones by Turner, who hasn't been crowding and forcing the fighting as he did the last time around. Jones, a good counterpuncher, cannot use his favorite weapon. And Turner, who is more at home rushing, is having to bide his time a little bit more between punches as well. 30 seconds left in round number two. Coming up, we're looking into the corner of Gil Turner. Gil Turner against Bobby Jones in the white trunks. Trunks working hard to land those combinations, but he's running into a lot of fast-moving elbows and shoulders as Bobby Jones is doing nice defensive work and blocking them. In the white trunks, stepping up the pace now, forcing the fighting some more. Fifty seconds to go in round number three. In the corner of Bobby Jones, who is obviously wishing Turner would come to him a little bit more. He's trying to step up the pace and force Turner to change his tactics. But Turner is playing a patient and waiting game and answering the rushing of Bobby Jones when he tries one with a series of quick combination punches, usually two to the body, and then the last two going up toward the head. Let's go! attempts by Turner are blocked. The jaw of Gil Turner and shook him up a bit at that. There's about a minute to go in round number four. Bobby Jones is having himself a pretty good round. Bobby Jones threw. It was a case of Gil Turner pulling away and rolling with the punch. The punch did not snap his head around as it may have appeared. The arena in Philadelphia once again with the fifth round coming up. Gil Turner pictured here against Bobby Jones in the white trunks. Just under the left eyebrow of Gil Turner, which sort of evens that point up exactly with the previous fight when Turner's eye likewise was cut in about the same place in the last fight. Both cuts, this one and the previous one, showing up in the fifth round. Now and in the combinations, his third punch, the right hand, has been landing. Jones. It's going to run a lot of people over to him.